But my wife does not know how to behave herself in a dildo store. Somebody else's girlfriend not know how to be, our wife not know how to behave themselves in a dildo store? I thought dudes just know what it, you know, it's like a strip club. You sit there, you don't look at the other people, you feel creepy, you feel bad, you go home, wash your hands a lot. That's what you do at a strip club and at a dildo store. My wife thinks a dildo store is the funniest place on earth. Like it must be filled with ether. She's just tripping out. She's tripping balls. She loves it so much. About 4 or 5 months ago, one of her friends was getting married and they had a bachelorette party, which is like the dumbest thing. Like, let's get as drunk as we can until I cry with a tiara made out of rubber dicks and balloons. That's what a... And then let me call my fiance at 3 o'clock from a hotel room in, let's say, Santa Barbara and make him doubt every life decision that led up to getting engaged. That is what a bachelorette party is. That is, and bachelor parties are creeper too. Oh, we got it. Like, guys, I didn't have, my bachelor party was me and my two best friends playing Halo 3 online against teenagers on Xbox till 3 a.m. Want some more Mountain Dew, Sean? Hey. My wife married a dork, is what I'm saying. Bachelor parties are different. Bachelor parties are weird because, like, guys go to Vegas, like, yeah, dude, we got you a hooker. We got you this toilet seat to lick. I'm cool. I'm totally, you know what I mean? You get to put your head inside the elephant's ass at the zoo. No, I'm not excited, right? Because I know that hooker thing, like, it's like, isn't a bachelor party like a week before your wedding? So then you're just like incubating some weird STD that's going to come out in like Hawaii, like you're on a volcano. You're like, I don't know what it is, but it hurts. I need medicine. Please help me. I love you. Don't leave. And the helicopter takes off. So here's the deal. One of our friends is getting married. We had to go to the pleasure chest, which is our local. It's our local. Yeah, because it could be a chest, like a chest full of sex toys, or like a pleasure chest, like the front or back opening on a person. Double entendre. Gross. So gross. So we're there, and we're shopping for like rubber, like boner straws and whatever she's getting. And I know the game. I've been to one of those stores. You go in, you don't look at anyone, you certainly don't fucking talk, and it's not a time to start taking pictures on your BlackBerry. It's just, it's an unspoken kind of creepy thing. There's dudes in trench coats with passenger vans on them probably. You don't know. Shady people left and right. So we're there, and she's going freaking crazy because she can't believe, oh my God, look at this. Holy shit, there's a wall of rubber dicks. Like, it's a dildo store. It's a wall of rubber dicks. You take one down, try it on, put it in your holster and leave. That's what you do. And the dildo store is like this. You keep it tucked in and you observe everything. Then you wait till you go out in the car and that's when you download. You download. Like, what do you see? Oh my God, I saw a guy with a glass eye, you know, jerking off in the bucket, in the swing set section. Because they have a swing set section. There's like they sell those. They're like $500. Those that you hang in your living room, I guess. So when people come over, you put fruit and stuff in it, and hey, you know, want a Capri Sun? They're cold. No! That's where you spin your wife with your boner. Why would I ever eat out of that thing? So we're in the dildo store, and at one point she turns and goes, oh my God, butt plugs! They sell butt plugs! And I turn and I go, I know, that man 10 feet away is paying $39.95 for that exact one. And now he's crying. Good job, man. Good job. Made a butt plug shopper cry, which I have a feeling he's already be crying later on in the night, guys, so really. Because they're so big. That's my, have you ever seen, like, you think, oh, maybe like, they're like the size of like a Folgers can, kind of widowed and widowed like down. And I don't, like a running start in a tub of Crisco, I couldn't get that inside myself. And I'm a large person. That's all I'm saying. They look like a painful device, right? I know. Next time you go, like, just ask to see the butt plugs. That's the best thing. Like, go to a place like you're shopping, like to buy a car and be a real dick. $39.95, I'll give you $28 right now. Do you have a floor model? I don't care, refurbished. Oh, really? No, they don't. It's not a product you too much. It's okay. But it's the dildo store is awful. You know where else we got? So we went to the dildo store. She can't go back. She's been banned.